bonding works. We'll use his DNA for the 11.
CRISPR is a term. It's bacteria have an immune system that cuts invaders, cuts their DNA. And what we've done now, as scientists, we've now utilized that system, take it out of the bacteria, and we use it to create designer mutations, designer gene changes in animals and also in humans. So it's a bacterial immune system that corrects genes. And we use it all the time now. It's actually, what's interesting about it is we've been able to mutate genes for many years, but this is dial up a gene mutation. You can choose exactly where you want to make it. And recently, a Chinese researcher in our field came out and said he's engineered a couple of twin girls with CRISPR to be resistant to HIV, the AIDS virus.
The field of DNA editing in medical genetics is changing much faster than we think. AI and CRISPR technology have been making revolutionary changes to the field of medicine. Artificial intelligence is being applied in identification of harmful genes and treatment of disease. Though the specific use cases and applications are numerous, the importance of AI in healthcare and its impact on the biotech industry could grow exponentially in the near future. Multiple new gene editing technologies in addition to artificial intelligence will cause major changes in healthcare. The gene editing tool, CRISPR, short for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats, could help us to reprogram life. It gives scientists more power and precision than they ever had to alter human DNA. This new power includes the possibility of making people smarter. Even before CRISPR was used on human embryos, the technology was used to modify simple animals. There, the goal was to demonstrate that the technology worked. These experiments made us aware that with CRISPR, we could do a lot more than we previously thought we could. Scientists use CRISPR to change, delete, or add DNA to any organism. From a human embryo to a pig to a wheat crop, CRISPR does this by subduing a specific part of the genome and then injecting a new piece of DNA into the genome instead.
So CRISPR is an acronym for basically a system that is from bacteria that they use to kill and destroy the DNA of invading organisms like a virus. But we can now use that system to cut and change our own genomes. It's basically a DNA cutting enzyme that doesn't cut randomly. You can give it a barcode in the form of what's called an RNA molecule that tells where that enzyme will cut in the genome. Let's say you have a terrible gene that's causing heart disease. We take this CRISPR system, we say, here's where you need to go to cut. We can tell the enzyme to go and cut it, put it into your cells, it'll go cut it and destroy that enzyme and delete it. And you can also use it to cut the genome and insert new pieces. So you can both subtract and add DNA at will now, not just randomly, but what's important is you can tell it where to go. And that's the big breakthrough.
Currently, gene editing is already used in research fields such as human health, agriculture, and environmental protection. However, CRISPR as a tool for human genetic engineering is still in its early stage development. With the development of CRISPR as a tool for genetic engineering, it is possible that more scientific advances are to come. Let us consider the possible advantages and disadvantages of this technology. In case of diseases, CRISPR has a lot of potential advantages. CRISPR technology holds a lot of promises, but we should be careful in applying it to humans, animals, and plants, as it may promote and accelerate some negative phenomena on the environment and on humans. Moreover, many potential side effects have not been analysed yet. Could it be conceivable that at one point in the future, we could increase the average IQ of the population? According to UCLA neurobiologists, the work in mice demonstrates the answer may be yes. Sometimes a person or animal is born with a mutation in their genome. These mutations can be small or large, and they can have many different effects. Such mutations are often purposeless or random, and they can have no effect on our intelligence. This is shown by the fact that gene mutations that happened millions of years ago are still present in the genes of living organisms on Earth. Evolution has had plenty of time to correct them and eradicate them, but many of them are still there. In fact, many of the mutations that show up in human DNA are harmful. The apparently large genetic contribution has detrimental effects on everyday life, ranging from a person being slightly more vulnerable to certain diseases, to mental retardation, to causing death immediately after birth. CRISPR technology in the future could enable efficient and affordable treatment of diseases such as diabetes, Alzheimer's, cystic fibrosis, muscular dystrophy, or even rheumatoid arthritis.
We believe we understand how to slow aging. There are genes that predispose you to a long life. We could make offspring, a family that would potentially live a lot longer. Actually, there are drugs that are in development to actually correct genetic diseases, such as vision loss. What we're showing is, in mice at least, we can reverse the age of the retina and restore the vision of old mice. So we'd reprogram the eye to be young again. So we now know that there's a set of genes called reprogramming factors, also known as Yamanaka factors, that are named after this Japanese fellow who won the Nobel Prize in 2012. These factors are used all over the world, even to reprogram skin cells, other cells, to be what we call pluripotent stem cells. These are cells that can be used to make new organs or new blood cells. But what people hadn't tried until recently was, can you do this in a living animal? Or are you just going to mess it up? And what we found out is that if you do it the wrong way, you mess up the animal and it'll die. But what we've shown for the first time in this paper is you can do it in a safe way. And not only that, reverse the clock, make the cells young, and restore how they work and get back vision.
CRISPR was originally designed as a technique for editing the DNA in living organisms, but its uses and capabilities have expanded substantially. It is now used widely for biomedical research, including research into human genetics. One of the main issues concerning technologies such as CRISPR-Cas9 is accuracy and safety, as mistakes can have significant and dangerous consequences when it comes to an individual's genome. However, CRISPR technology has a lot of potential benefits. It is not a completely new idea, and it can help treat diseases and genetic anomalies, and many scientists have made potential progress that CRISPR-Cas9 may be safer than viral therapies. Many people have expressed concerns about CRISPR technologies because they think it is incredibly controversial. There are questions of ethics and fairness, as it could probably only be available to the wealthy to create designer babies with increased levels of intelligence. Intelligence is too complex to engineer. However, many researchers think that intelligence is influenced by genes and environment. Genes affect the developing baby's brain, and environmental factors influence how the brain is used. Thus, it is possible that genetically engineered babies could be smarter as a result of the increased amount of oxygen to the developing brain thanks to gene editing. Research experiments already exist that create smart mouse babies. The question is whether it is going to be possible to accomplish the same with human beings.
And in the mice, to restore the vision, we have this three-gene combination of these Yamanaka reprogramming genes. We put them into the eye, and then we turn them on with a drug called doxycycline. It's the same drug we can feed to the mice, turns on the reprogramming genes for a few weeks, restores their vision back to a young mouse, and then we just take away the doxycycline, an antibiotic, and the mice have their vision back. That's the future, that you'll get a delivery of this virus, you'll take the antibiotic for a few weeks, be fully rejuvenated, and the doctor says, come back in a couple of decades, we'll fix you again, or we'll give you some antibiotic in a couple of decades. But then it gets really weird if you have if you engineer your children to have this system, and you have people engineered to be able to be reversed in their age, or let's say they have an accident and their optic nerve gets damaged, or they lose their hearing, give them a dose, an IV of antibiotics, and they become just like an embryo. They can rejuvenate, they can regrow their optic nerve, regrow their spine, fixed, back like new.
It may be possible that in the future, our genealogical records might be included in computer databases, and future computer programs could use it. The advancements in artificial intelligence and CRISPR technology can make it possible to one day create a new breed of human-machine hybrids. However, the question concerning the safety of such technique in relation to humans is ongoing. We do not fully understand all the mechanisms related to the editing of the human genome. Additionally, the long-term and short-term effects of the gene editing interventions in humans are still unclear. CRISPR has given the scientific community a great leap. The prospect of improving our understanding of the genome will likely stimulate advances in both artificial intelligence and predictive medicine. The possibility of altering the sequences of genes and correcting the mistakes that were previously irreversible opens many new possibilities for research. Nevertheless, for now, genetic editing technology is still incapable of making the hundreds of changes presumably necessary to make a super intelligent human. But the corresponding ethical issues deserve serious attention before these capabilities become a reality. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.